Chelsea 3, Brighton 2. It was another game full of drama. Chelsea going 2-0 up, thanks to goals from set plays. And then the man wearing the captain's armband, having already been booked, saw a second yellow. Where do you want to start with this one? It finished Chelsea 3, Brighton 2. This could have been anything after Gallagher got sent off.
Yeah, I mean, it's one of those games that's weird, right? Because, I mean, Chelsea have won, and they'll take that, especially after what happened against Newcastle, right? I mean, it's sort of this up-and-down way of Chelsea where you're trying to make out who they are, what they are, how good they are. And at the end of the day, even with this win, I think nothing more of them than a mid-table team that they are right now, because there's nothing special about this team. Again, I was more disappointed with Chelsea than the fact that they've won. So it's kind of hard for us to maybe for me to have a go at them, because wins are wins. But I just don't know where they are. I didn't see that spirit that I saw from Liverpool. I saw two set pieces, 2-0, where I felt that they needed to go after that and show some energy, close the game down, make people forget about that loss. And I didn't see any of that. In fact, it was an open invitation for a Brighton team that's decimated, just like Chelsea. When I say decimated, not only injuries, no left fullbacks, right? Because you see Lamptey and Estupiñán not there. You're talking about 3-4 key players being on the bench, because on Thursday, now, mind you, Brighton are in Europe, not Chelsea, who have had the whole week to prepare for this. And, you know, this is Brighton that won away in Athens, our second to Olympic Marseille in Europe. And for some reason, we think Chelsea should be better, but they're not. I don't think they are getting better in many ways. I was very, very disappointed. Again, in discipline. Last week, Reece James, the captain, gets sent off. This week, you have Conor Gallagher, the captain, getting sent off. Last week, that indiscipline, silly fouls, 19 of them. This week, 16 of them. I didn't see anything that I like, to be quite honest. And I don't think their fans did. It was like a church. I mean, it is Sunday after all, but... Mark, I mean, they are so, so far away from the Chelsea that I think we remember and their fans want them to be.
Interesting you mentioned that, Janusz, and I want to follow up on that, because it's a really good point. John Terry, captain, leader, legend, the banner is still there every home game. I think I'm right in saying, and please correct me if I'm wrong, that Reece James, when sent off last week, was wearing the captain's armband. So if that's the case, that's back-to-back weeks where the man who's meant to be leading by example doesn't, is just reckless. Reece James last week, slightly different this week for Conor Gallagher, because it was two tackles for him that did for him. But does that tell us something about the club in general, that the leadership needs to be better? Because without that, they're just a ragtag bunch of expensive, decent players that don't have much leadership or guidance.
Absolutely. I didn't see any of that. And you know, from time to time, I think most of us kind of want, you know, I don't want to say want, but we just imagine this Chelsea that it's eventually, because it's Chelsea, for no other reason than that. And we can sit here and talk about how many young players, how many players came in, and it takes time. But I think, you know, Pochettino has to take responsibility for that, because I don't think these players are responding either in a way that you'd imagine. Because, you know, I look at that team and we talk about front lines, right? And I was thinking the other day, and I look at Jackson, I look at Sterling, Mudryk, Gallagher, and even Cole Palmer, right? I mean, think about it. I mean, they're nowhere near the front lines of the top teams. I'm talking Liverpool, Manchester City. I'm talking Arsenal. I could probably throw in their Spurs, maybe Villa, maybe for sure even Newcastle. And you say to yourself how good they really are, because, you know, people are going to tell us that it takes time. There's so much talent in young players, and I don't see it. And the leadership, you know, comes from that. I think comes from confidence as well, obviously. But this is a team that kind of feels like randomly goes out there week in and week out and gives us a little bit of hope, a game against, say, Arsenal. But then, right, that leadership collapses, right? 2-0, great game. You say to yourself, oh, maybe they're getting somewhere. Then you look at Manchester City, 4-4, okay, defensively a disaster, but four goals against City, a good result. And then comes game like this. So it's a bit weird for me to talk about it, because at the end of the day, they won. But again, this Brighton team almost came back I wouldn't have given that penalty. I think it was a wrong decision. You've mentioned Caicedo should have been seen a second yellow card. And it almost feels like they lost the game. Apologies, Chelsea fans, but that's the way I see it. I don't see really any progress that's going to materialize anytime soon.
Not even with Nkunku coming back from a knee injury over the next week or two?
Christ, too bad that you made that point and not me, because I had it written down. Unless, of course, Nkunku changes that, which I suppose is possible. We saw him here in the United States, Mark, in the preseason. He looked the part. We know what he's capable of doing. So I suppose that could change the equation from a talented player like that. But, I mean, it would change my opinion about where they stand in terms of front lines, but I don't think it's going to change anything in terms of where Chelsea are going to be at the end of the season.